Good day, friends. It is me, HLModTech, and I've got a new Anet ET4 Plus printer. My friends, you know it's time to update it, so let's get cracking. All right, ladies and gentlemen, before we do this upgrade, you need to make sure that you have got the printer you think you got. So if we hit information, you can see I do have the ET4 Pro or the ET4 Plus. You can also double check by making sure you've got the automatic bed leveling. Friends, now that we've got our printer figured out, let's actually get the stuff that we're gonna have to use to do the updating. So this link will be in the description. It is how you get to the Anet firmware page to download it. You do need to sign in. I simply sign in with Google. Once that is complete, you can see the file right here, and we're gonna simply download it by clicking on this arrow right here and then choosing the download button. I have downloaded this several times. I'm just going to save it with a different name. We need to use a special tool to update this firmware. This is by Karl. He has got a website that showed us how to fix the ET4 if you had a bad flash. It also is how we update this with what's called the STLink version 2. Here's a link you can buy it for. It's only $6.29 on Amazon. And then we need this utility, which we can get right here. When you hit this, you simply download it. Save it to your downloads folder. I've done it more than once, but I'll save it again. And now I'll show you how to put these all in the right place so that we can use them. So if you're using Windows, I'm going to hit the little arrow here and do show in folder. I'm going to right click on the ET4 one and I'm going to simply hit extract all. And I'm even going to delete that ET4 and I'm going to just tell it to extract all to the main folder. And let's watch what it does. See how it still gave us an ET4 folder? I was pretty sure that's what was going to happen. I am going to quickly click on that little folder and rename it so I can keep track. This will be the ET4 Pro or Plus folder. And then I'm going to unzip the firmware. When we do extract all on this, I'm going to delete its big name as well and just tell it extract. Once again, it makes the folder for me. All right, friends, just so you know, this hyphen does not work with the STLink, so we could rename it, but instead my solution is we're gonna double click, find the file we want, simply cut it, return to our ET4 Pro or Plus folder, and paste it there. So now it's ready for flashing. And then we need the software. To get the software, I'm gonna do the extract all. Not gonna put it in a special folder, and I'm gonna just tell it extract. And this will give us the file that we can then install so we actually have this on our computer. And let's do the install process. Tell it yes. Let it run through all the little things it needs to do. Give it a next, a yes. Let it have its default location. Next on the drivers, finish, and finish. All right, time to snag your STLink version 2. We're using the three wires on the top right, the clock, the I/O, and the ground. I put those wires in the order black, brown, and white. And then inside your ET4 Pro, you need to find these pins. See that G? That is where the ground is going to go, which is the black one. Then we're going to put the white one, and then we're going to put the brown one. Alright friends, so double check your labels, make sure yours show up the same as mine, and then make sure you plug in those wires the same way. And now we can move on to getting ready for the flashing. Alright friends, so on just about every one of these that I've opened up, this protective shield has been flipped down. So I have flipped that up. You can see that once again we've got it with the black, then the white, and then the brown. Alright, I'm going to just spin this around and connect it to the USB extension that I've got. And remember, we have to plug in the printer and power it up, but make sure you keep your fingers away from all those electrical things. Once it fires up, we need to launch that STLink. I've got mine on the desktop. If you don't have it on the desktop, you can type ST space L and it'll show up there as well. Whatever bin you had before, make sure you right click it and close it because you're probably doing a different kind of printer. And then you want to read or you want to connect to the target. And then you don't want to ever lose your backup. So click file and choose save file as. Make sure you're in that ET4 Pro folder. And we want to do ET4 Pro original. So that way you can always go back to the firmware if you need it. And that quickly it will pull it from your machine. And then you're ready to move on to the very next step. All right, friends, then we need to simply click on that binary file move to our downloads folder and find that ET4 Pro folder we created, and we need to populate it with that ET4 Pro or Plus bin file. Once you've got it connected, once again double checking to make sure that you got it powered on, you can hit Target and Program and click Start to let it do its magic. Alrighty friends, so I have moved the ET4 Plus or Pro back to her home. You'll notice it shows up with the correct screen, but look at this, nothing's clickable. What you need to do is press and hold for about 5 seconds, and it goes into a calibration mode. Then you just need to make sure you calibrate those four corners. And once it says calibration complete, tap again, and now you're in control of your ET4 Pro. Alrighty, so that's how easy it is to upgrade the ET4 Pro or Plus to Marlin 2.0 using that STLink version 2. Stay tuned, friends. I will be showing you how to do a first print and set it up for Cura and everything else as well, but right now we've got that firmware installed. Friends, if you found the video useful, please give it a like. If you got a question, comment, or suggestion, add it down below. If you haven't subscribed yet, what are you waiting for? Smash that subscribe button, and last but not least, hit that notification bell if you want to be the first to know when there's a brand new video from me, HLModTech. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.